I'm sorry if I seem uninterested, or I'm not listening, or I'm indifferent. Truly, I ain't got no business here, but since my friends are here, I just came to kick it. But really, I would rather be at home all by myself, not in this room with people who don't even care about my well-being. I don't dance, don't ask, I don't need a boyfriend, so you can go back. Please enjoy your party, I'll be here somewhere in the corner under clouds of marijuana with this boy who's hopping. I can hardly hear over this music I don't listen to, and I don't want to get with you, so tell my friends that I'll be over here.
Thanks so much for watching Paige's of Beauty, and if you're new to my channel, thanks so much for stopping by. Guys, today's video is going to be on my new fabulous gray box braids, my baby bump, and also May favorites that I am currently loving. So if you guys are interested, don't forget to hit the subscribe button, and also hit the little bell next to the subscribe button so that you guys are notified every time I post to Paige's of Beauty. So guys, keep on watching, and don't forget to give me a thumbs up. So guys, today's video is going to be on my new fabulous gray box braids. I recently had these put in by my cousin. She does hair, and she's really, really good at braiding, and I missed my box braids so much, and I finally got her to take the day and take the time to do my hair, but it was so worth it because my hair, honestly guys, I love my box braids. Like, I think they look so pretty, and I think they're so cute. Yeah, so in today's video, I'm going to talk about my box braids and how I take care of them and what I will be using to treat my box braids, and also to make sure that my hair and my scalp stays very healthy. So a few of you, or most of you, should know by now I am expecting. So I have a little one on the way, and I will not be able to attend to my hair as I normally would if I wanted to just do bantu knots, or if I wanted to do a twist out or a wash and go. So I decided to go with another protective style for my natural hair, and I'm actually wearing box braids now. I have two different colors in my hair. I wear gray or black hair, and I had a ton of this hair left over, so because I was on a budget and I didn't want to spend a ridiculous amount of money, I'll make sure to put like the exact color down below. But this gray is like a 51, or like a 251 shade range, and then the dark part is actually also a blend, and I buy it like this with this blend already. So this is a shade 280. I know for a fact this is 280. So if you guys are like in the hair store and you're wondering like what shades are, those are my shades. I did have to like dip my ends in hot water, and I'm gonna like dip them every week or every other week just to make sure that I keep the frizz down on the ends and they look sleek and they still look really nice. So what I'm gonna be using in my hair, now that it's braided up and it's in a protective style, I am going to be using, and I don't have much of this left, this is the Topical Roots shampoo spray. This one here is by the brand B&B, and it says that it's going to clean and deposit anti-itch, you know, like this one here, the nozzle is actually broken. So guys, what I do is I actually take product and I put it in a different spray bottle and I spray it onto my roots when I feel like it's time for me to pre-poo or to shampoo. I don't really like dousing my hair under a sink full of water or the shower head, just because that's a lot of work to do, and really I'm just trying to clean my scalp. I can clean my hair later. So this one here is made with pineapple and guava, and it's really great. It's gonna soothe the scalp, remove buildup, cleans the hair, it's rinse free, it prevents an itchy and dry scalp. It's gonna give great deposits of luster and moisture, and it's great for all natural hairstyles. So this is what I'm gonna be using in my hair on a regular basis. And as for my oil, really cannot live without this oil. I know a lot of us use this oil. This is the black Jamaican castor oil. Un has me hipped onto this black Jamaican castor oil. And actually, guys, this is the Sunny Isles brand. To me, this is the best. This is the one to get, and I have it in extra dark, and it's also gonna help and aid in growth. The last thing that I wanted to mention that I'll be using in my hair, when I do go to shampoo or to condition my hair, I am going to be using a conditioner. Whether I'm co-washing with this conditioner, or it's going to be a leave-in, or if I'm gonna create a leave-in with this conditioner, it is the OGX Renewing Plus Argan Oil of Morocco. this is an amazing conditioner, and this was featured in my hair care product haul, or my hair haul for naturals, and I was talking about a bunch of products that I really liked for my hair. This I love. I will always love this conditioner. It moisturizes the hair so well. So I said, I'm gonna need something that's gonna put the moisture back into my hair. So this is the conditioner that I'm gonna use. It smells so good, and it's just, it's so great because it really penetrates the hair shaft. Okay guys, so the next thing I'm gonna talk about in the video is my baby bump. I have a ever so growing belly, and I do know what I am expecting, but I am not ready to reveal it just yet. I'm gonna leave a few more clues and hints and surprises around my channel. Maybe if you guys already know, but I'm like, why am I even trying? I am very excited, and so far so good. Everything is going really well with my pregnancy. I have gained officially 20 pounds. I don't know if the camera shows it. I don't know if you guys can see it, but I feel it. I'm a very naturally petite girl anyway, so I carry my weight very well. I'm not saying, oh, I think I'm fat, and but no, I do feel heavier, totally, for sure. But the baby is healthy, I'm healthy. It's gonna be predicted to be at a pretty little hefty weight, actually, my expected delivery, like the weight of the baby. And so I'm keeping myself very busy. I'm going to a lot of mother and me classes, and I'm learning all of what resources are available out there for new first-time mommies, and basically I'm learning everything that I can within this time frame and then some. So I wanted to show you guys my little bump. Oh, come back. So far, this is my baby bump. I can't wait to meet my baby, and I can't wait to hold it and to love it and to just squeeze it and smother it and give it all this fabulousness. So yeah, I actually had a subscriber shout me out, or she put me on blast, and she's like, I see your baby bump, I see that sticking out, and I'm like, oh, okay, alright, holla girl, I see you. So that was very fun, and I just feel so supported, and a lot of you are like so excited, and I got a really crazy response when I initially posted little things on like my social media page, and you guys made me even like twice as excited, you know, like just that rush of feedback, like it was so warming, and I can't wait. So yes guys, stay tuned on that. I cannot wait, and thank you guys so much for all your fabulous, wonderful comments and your love. So much love, sending me great energy, great vibes. I love it so much. It makes me feel really good, and it helps keep all the stress and the anxiety down, and it's been going really well. Yeah, so thanks so much guys. Okay guys, so the next thing I want to talk to you guys about is, listen, I think I can honestly say I am so late to the bandwagon. I am so late to the game. I have totally been living up under a rock, and I am just now getting hipped, or like keen on, to these Mink lashes. So I was on YouTube, and I was doing all of this browsing, and I learned about all these lashes. Like, I know Huda Beauty has her own line of lashes, and I think after that, the whole idea just went way over my head, you know? And I know they were like totally super expensive. So now everyone is on this Mink lash, and you know, create your own Minks and blah, blah, blah. Okay, so I totally ordered Mink lashes from eBay online, and once I get them, I'm gonna totally do a review to show you guys before I really, really crack and do the big purchase and buy the actual Mink lashes. I mean, like the Lily Lash, and there's so many like brands, and they can get pretty pricey. So I decided to make my own pair first and order some less expensive ones before I do the big purchase. So first I wanted to show you my Mink lashes. And I do have them on today. This is the pair of Mink lashes that I created myself. So guys, tell me what you think. I just used a pair of Forever 21 lashes. They were very thin. They were like almost invisible. then. And then I just took some Ardell individual lashes and I kind of just build and layered my own style and my own type of lash. So yes, tell me, please be honest and let me know. I think they look nice, like they don't look bad, but I don't think I would do it again. Just because it was very time consuming and it was very meticulous and it was very tedious to do, and I got annoyed at a few points, and I just don't think it's something that I would redo. But I think for the first time and for actually like filming in them, I think they look really nice. So yeah. Okay, yes, so guys, I really hope that you enjoyed this video, and I hope that you guys can share a comment or two and tell me what you're loving for this month. So yeah, don't forget to comment, rate, and subscribe, and guys, don't forget to thumbs up this video. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you guys